Made, and we're gonna rejoice and be glad in Him. Amen. Amen. Let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, thank you so much for the session of your word. I want to thank you for you being so gracious to us. It has taken your hand for us to be here. Blessed be your name. Today, as we continue to share your word, Father, I thank you for what is in the spiritual realm. Thank you for the word that is within the inner recesses of the will of God, that we move forward. My God, I pray that you use me to bring transformation. Use me, Jehovah, to change lives. Help me, Jehovah, that I may lift and raise life to real meaning. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. God bless you. Let's turn our Bibles, have your seat. We are turning our Bibles to Exodus chapter number 14. Exodus chapter number 14, let's go there. This is part two of the message. We are moving forward. And I'm glad to see all of you that are in the house today. God bless you. There has been some months even before we met with some of you. And also thank you those that are watching, my viewers, God bless you so much. I count you blessed and I thank you for tuning in. God bless you. When you look at Exodus chapter number 14, Bible says in verse number 14, the Lord will fight for you and you shall hold your peace. The Lord will fight for you and you shall hold your peace. Verse 15. And the Lord said to Moses, why do you cry to me? Tell the children of Israel to go forward. I want to build from where we left on Sunday that we are moving forward. Remember, this is the time the children of Israel, it seemed like they were stuck next to the Red Sea. And they had already complained and made noise to the man of God, Moses. They were very unhappy with the situation that they were brought from Goshen, that was in the land of captivity, the land of bondage. And the Bible records they were very unhappy with Moses. And after they complained, the Bible says Moses told them to tune in and to make sure their hearts are cool, they focus and they do not panic. And then after that, if I go comes and tell them, I am going to fight for you. I am going to fight for you. But the point was, it is no time to cry. It is time to go forward. It is time to go forward. We are living in times when we need to hear the same voice of the Lord telling us, there is need to step forward. We go on. Going forward is where we find our solution.
Now, why is God talking of fighting for them? I want to tell every Christian under my voice, God will not fight nothing. There must be enemies to be fought. When you hear God telling you, I'll be on your side, I'm going to fight for you. In other words, God is declaring war on your behalf and against your enemies. Somebody say that. So if you thought you would live without enemies, without adversaries, I want you to know God is interested in gaining glory by fighting and defeating your enemies. And when you know that, then you go to the side of God and you hear Him. May I say this? There are two types of losers in the battle. Two types of losers. Losers, number one, they are those who miss a law for their past. And losers, number two, they are those who are held back by their bitter past. Those two will lose the battle. The children of Israel were missing Egypt. They were telling Moses, we ought to have been back there. Where are you bringing us to a place where there are no graves? We ought to have stayed and served the Egyptians. That's a group number one of losers. I want to say this. Your destiny is not and should not be dictated by your past. Your destiny should be dictated by the will and the might of God. Let me say it again. You should not be dictated by your past for you to get on. You need to move on because the best is ahead. Hallelujah. Let me say this. Mountains behind you should not be allowed to shoot forward. Don't allow them to shoot from your back and they go ahead of you. They should not introduce your destiny. You are the one to remain ahead of your challenges, ahead of your obstacles. Hallelujah. Can I also say, when you cry, you stick to the problem. But when you speak and take action, you create a movement. I say again, the moment you are crying because of your troubles, you are sticking there. But the moment you shift from crying and you speak hope to yourself, you speak the word of God, the word of destiny, you create a movement to your destiny. Can I assure you that the best is ahead? Mark that. When God is saying, go forward, you need to know you are going forward and for the rest. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I don't want to see you stuck somewhere like a monument. You should be a great movement moving to your destiny. And that's why when you look at Philippians chapter 3, Philippians chapter number 3, I love the scripture I find here written by Apostle Paul. He is talking about something. Philippians is the letter. Those who are doing Bible study with me, you can be sure I'm also reading it, because today we are in Philippians chapter number 3. Look at verse 13. Brethren, I do not count myself to have apprehended, but one thing I do, forgetting those things which are behind and reaching forward to those things which are ahead. Let me repeat that verse before I go to the next one. Brethren, now I'm talking to you like Apostle Paul. Brethren, my brothers and sisters, I do not count myself to have apprehended. In other words, I have not attained, I have not reached my destiny. But for me to go to my destiny, there is one thing I must do. Forgetting those things which are behind and reaching forward. Somebody say forward.
Forward.
Reaching forward and to those things which are ahead. I'm not talking to people who would be struggling to rise up from certain quarters and certain dimensions of life, but I'm so encouraged to know when God speaks, He acts. If He says go forward, He is ready to act on your behalf. The enemy would want you to spend your whole life bitter, disappointed, frustrated, in agony because of your bitter past, because of what you are seeing behind. You are seeing fell and the chariot and the horse. The enemy would like you to stand there and just look at your enemies without moving forward. And God is relocating you, shifting you from being tied by the things behind you so that you can move forward. I want to speak to our hearts. Coronavirus has been dictating some situations, dictating some dimensions of our living. But I can tell you, we are not going to accept to be tied there. We are going to move forward. Our families must move forward. Our businesses must move forward. Our marriages must move forward. Listen to me, somebody. The word is go forward. And you see, sometimes when we are held back by the past, we become so irritated in life. Can I tell you? Regrets and worries about what you have faced. I want to tell you, they will never give you peace. You need to know when you take your mind forward, when you dare you are afraid and move on in your spirit and you move on in your mind and you wait expectantly ahead of your life, and it gives you peace, because there is always peace when you sustain yourself in hope. The past and behind you will never encourage you as far as you are seeing enemies and adversaries, like it was the case of the children of Israel. Can I say the action is to move and the direction is forward? You cannot start, you remain stuck there. So there must be an action, and the action is to move. But where are you moving to? Sideways? No. Backwards? No. Upwards? You're going nowhere. You'll be here on earth, but the direction is forward. And this is where I say, if yesterday I lost my silver, I will look forward to my tomorrow, because I will find my gold there. Hallelujah. I say again, if you have lost your silver yesterday, please look forward, because you are finding your gold there. Did you know when the man I love so much, the man Job, when he looked at his past and discovered that everything is lost, he focused ahead and said, "For I know him whom I believe, even in this flesh is wasting, I myself will see God. I will see God." In other words, he said, "Tomorrow I have hope." Yes, yesterday, all my 10 children died. All my camels got burned. Everything I had got stolen. My servants died. Only one was remaining to come and report to me. Yes, yesterday, even my wife complained about it, that she did not get a comfort in what I'm going through. That is my yesterday. But one thing I know, I will see the Lord. Hallelujah. There is hope in your tomorrow. Give us Proverbs 23. Let me show you this. Proverbs 23, verse 1. number 18 is important. Remember, it is God fighting for us, but for Him to act, we must be ready to move forward. Because the victories of God are not yesterday. He is the God of the living. He is the God of this time and of tomorrow. Proverbs 23, verse 18. For sure there is hereafter. Amen. For sure there is a hereafter. And your hope will not be cut off. Oh my goodness. I feel like back in my chair. Listen to me. When the Bible talks of sure, that is the Bible, not a human being, just the writing. It is the inspiration of the Holy Spirit upon the writer. For sure, there is a hereafter. Listen to me, COVID-19, you may have come with all your teeth out, but I declare there is a hereafter. We are going to say after COVID-19, here we are. Yes, let them come in all manner of things. Let them throw stones at you, but their names are hereafter. Other versions say their names are made. One thing I love about seasons, they are never permanent. Even this one is not permanent. We're going to see a hereafter. Hey, hallelujah. Hope, our hope shall not be cut off. The devils are going to cut off our hope. Let them feel the shame because their age are hereafter. Yes, I may feel like my accounts are shaken. My economic power is shaken. Yes, my money may go to the kitchen and look at it and there is nothing. There seems to be very little or nothing in your cupboard. But let's listen to me. There is a hereafter. Amen. You may feel that you are tempted even to walk and leave your vehicle because fuel has been short. Shorted of fuel. Listen to me. I want to tell you, there is a hereafter. The children of Israel were there. Take us back to Exodus 14. Let me show you verse number 19. When they were already set to go forward, what will happen after God speaks? He comes to act. Verse number 19, the Bible says, and the angel of God went before the camp of Israel, moved and went behind them. And the pillar of cloud went from before them and stood behind them. Look at this. It was not the business of Israelites to go back. God designed that the angel is the one to go behind. Why? To bring a separation. Verse 20. The angel and the pillar, they are behind them. To bring separation. Look at it. So it came between the camp of the Egyptians and the camp of Israel. That it was a cloud and darkness to the one side, and it gave light by night to the other, so that the one did not come near the other all that night. I wanted to look at the night of the battle, the real battle. The children of Israel are moving forward. They are here. We have the Red Sea, and then we have the Egyptian. So the angel and the pillar of cloud came behind the children of Israel. I know some people interpret that verse. You know, as a Bible teacher, you go straight looking at some of the details in the world. Look at it. Many people may think the light is towards the children of Israel, and as they think the light is towards the people of Egypt, I would like you to go and study deeper and discover which side had the light. But one thing I want you to know, the angel and the pillar, they were always ahead of the children of Israel, shedding the light behind them. So that the children of Israel are following because they could see their surrounding and the light. So when the angel and the pillar came behind the children of Israel, you can be sure where the light is. The light is with the enemy. Are you following? And that could be a certain season. Somebody may feel now I'm doomed. I'm seeing darkness. And God is saying, move forward. Where? Because the reason why, have you ever done it scientifically? When you are in the dark, there's somebody who is in the light would be hard to see. But when you are in the light, whoever is in darkness is seeing you. Are you following this? Come on, that is sad. Now look at this. The enemies are there. Yes, we can see them. But God has a design. God has a plan. He is going to repeat this for a number of nights so that the children of Israel will be seen through that light how their enemies are getting destroyed. It is not enough for God to fight for you. You also need to see how he is fighting so that you may worship him. Hallelujah. Listen to me. You look at what is happening here this night. One thing you discover that when the children of Israel are there, now God wants to speak and say something. Let me say, my God knows how to keep you ahead. Every time you trust him, he knows how to keep you ahead. But verse 21, the Bible says, Moses, then Moses stretched out his hand over the sea, and the Lord caused the sea to go back by a strong east wind all the night, and made the sea into dry land, and the waters were divided. Next verse 22. So the children of Israel went into the midst of the sea on the dry ground, and the waters were a wall to them on their right hand and on their left. Hold on. Let me show you. Bible readers, sometimes you read and you see it casually on the side. Let me show you something. This Red Sea, you have all, those who have gone to Mombasa into the Indian Ocean, like where you have a ferry, how deep is that place? Look at this. These who are going to walk on the dry sea, you think it was flat and plain? No. By the way, Red Sea, the average depth is 490 meters. There are even places where it is over 3,000 meters deep. That's the Red Sea. When you talk of width, it extends even to 355 kilometers. That's why the volume of the water today, the volume of the water of the Red Sea, is over 233 cubic kilometers. What am I saying? I want you to see the scenario where you see that they passed through dry land in the middle of the sea. It's not a joke. This was the miracle of the miracles. This was a great thing. This was why God was telling them confidently, go forward. What could be happening? I don't know, it is not written, but I highly sense when the waters were going to the side, God must have raised the ground. Amen. Because it's not easy for them to go down there. Some are old, and they are coming up again. And don't think this was a simple thing. It was a goodness. And you see, God is willing to do all this, but they must maintain the attitude, the mindset of going forward. Can I tell you, when you step forward to believe God, the impossible will change. God is able to change the situation because it is His word. The miracle is in what He has said. In His word. Because the word creates even the way where there is no way. Hallelujah. The other thing you discover with God, I'm just showing you the scenario on the ground, the exegesis of the matter. Do you know, even today, the Red Sea carries the hottest waters that you find in the world. The world's hottest water or water sea you find in the Red Sea. Not only that, very salty, the saltiest. That is why you find before you get to Mombasa, because Red Sea connects with the Indian Ocean, you see, through the desert. And you find when you are going down to Mombasa, you find just a little bit of the heat and a little bit of the salt. But up there, no joke. So God is dealing with the environment for His children to have breakthrough. I declare this is a servant of God. May God deal with your environment. May God deal with your difficult situation. May the Lord deal with your circumstances for your breakthrough. He is God that will remain God. Oh, hallelujah. Verse 23, please. Now let's look at now. Now, there's something about now. Let's see how God makes a way. Oh, hallelujah. Humans. Look at now, chapter 1, yes, verse 3. The Lord is slow to anger and great in power. Remember that. And will not at all acquit the wicked. He cannot surrender to the Egyptians. They must face it. The Lord has His way in the wind and in the storm, and the clouds are the dust on His feet. Before you go to verse 4, the Lord has His way even in the whirlwind. If you go to your mother tongue and you read the Bible in your mother tongue, that whirlwind is like the demons of the women. I don't know whether it's that interpretation. They are called gomasiaka, for those who can understand the language. You know, and people think it's women getting mad. No, it is when there is a whirlwind, all ladies must be careful, because if they are not careful, all their tunics and their clothes will be blown over their heads. That's why they become crazy, to ensure they will not be hurt naked. Oh, sorry for that. But this is why. Because even in such times, if at all there is no will, when else can women behave like that? It is when the situation is so bad, when things are not working, when there is something to cry out about. Women can go sometimes, they forget, and they address themselves unknowingly. Like our ladies in Kenya, at one time, they decided to go naked because they needed to secure the forest of this country. Listen to me. Even when there is an issue that can cause that kind of a shame, God will make a way. Yes. Can you shout to your neighbor, wherever they are, tell them, God will make a way. Verse 4 says, He rebukes the sea and makes it dry. That is clear. And dries up all the rivers. Bashan and Carmel wither, and the flower of Lebanon wilts. Give me some verse 19. We are still seeing making the way. Psalm 77, verse 19. Your way is in the sea. I like that. Can I tell someone listening to me now? Even that sea of problems, the way of the Lord is in there. God is able to make his way. So if, when he is saying, go forward, and you are seeing all the issues about the sea, the waters, he knows what he is saying, because he's going to make it a way. The way is in the waters. And your footsteps were not known. I love that. The footsteps of God are not known. And that's why we surrender to him by faith, because if he says, we go forward, we may not see his footsteps, so that we follow them, but he will follow the voice of his word. Amen. Take us back to Exodus number 14. I think I'm coming to wind up verse 23 very quickly. Let's look at something here. Verse 23. Now, I want you to see how it will work. I want you to see how it will work. Remember, Moses had already opened the sea. They are now walking. The Egyptians, the Bible says in verse 23, and the Egyptians pursued and went after them into the midst of the sea, all Pharaoh's horses, his chariots, and his horsemen. Verse 24. Now it came to pass in the morning watch that the Lord looked down upon the army of the Egyptians through the pillar of fire and cloud, and he troubled the army of the Egyptians. I know there are questions here. If that is how wide the sea was, did they cross overnight? I know you ask yourself. It is not specified in the Bible, but you can tell this drama was taking some place. Are you following? But look at this. Something very important that the Egyptians pursued. Question number one, did they realize that this was a miracle already done by the God of Israel? Yes, they could see the waters. They could see the waters, but listen to me. And I want to say this prophetically. The miracle is meant for you and not for your enemy. And I declare it again. The miracle, when you move forward, that miracle happening and the way created is yours. And if your enemy is still adamant and want to pursue, thinking he will kill you, he will be killed by your miracle. Well, look at this. I want you to see this, that when they pursued, they are following their chariots, their soldiers, their horses. There's something that is going to happen. The Bible says in verse 24, and God troubled the Egyptian army. May God trouble your enemies. Well, I want to declare in this land and in the globe, may God trouble coronavirus. It has troubled us now. May God now trouble this sickness. May God release his wrath against COVID-19. Here's what I told you. We can wake up one morning and we wonder what has happened. That's the God I believe. He's God of miracles. May he trouble. And when you hear the morning watch, it is the morning of 3 a.m. to 6 a.m. According to the Roman colonial government, the Jews started observing the watches of the Romans. Jews and their four. But when they were colonized by the Romans, they started having 3 watches. Which watch? This is where you find the watchmen. They were engaged and employed at 2 watches. One could take watch number 1 from 6 p.m. To 9 p.m. Another one will take a second watch, 9 p.m. to midnight. Are you getting? And then when you come to, the other one was taking from midnight to 3 a.m. Those are the Romans, not the Jews. The Roman watches, they were like that. And the fourth one and the last one was taking 3 a.m. To 6 a.m. Marching. When we tell people to pray early in the morning, that is the season, the watch of a major breakthrough. It was observed, and this is where miracles take place. If you are praying the whole night, that watch of 3 a.m. to 6 a.m., expect your breakthroughs and miracles. This is the same watch that Jesus left the mountain, prayed, and walked on the sea, the fourth watch of the night. And this is the watch the Bible says, and God, look at verse 25, and the Bible says, this time, come on, verse 25, and he took off their chariot wheels. This is God now. He's looking at them, he is watching, and he is taking off their wheels. So that they drove them with difficulty. And the Egyptians say, let us flee from the face of Israel, for the Lord fights for them against the Egyptians. Now the enemies are here, Nikubai. Their wheels are not moving. They are getting off. Some versions say he made them to jump. Those drivers who drive sometimes the wheel may jump and you are able to move, you're not able to drive. He said to me, in that scenario, God made their wheels not to move. And they are realizing God of Israel is fighting against us. But can I tell you, it was too late for them to turn back. Do you know what God was waiting for? God is a timer. God knows how to time. He is a God of love. I want to tell you, the Israelites are walking ahead. Can you see the picture? When the last man of the Israelites got off the sea, the last one of the Egyptians entered the sea. And now what will happen is verse 27, and I close with that. Moses stretched out his hand over the sea. And when the morning appeared, the sea returned to its full depth. Mark the word, depth. Are you getting that? To full depth. While the Egyptians were fleeing into it, not outside it, into it. God will ensure that whatever has troubled us is going to remain defeated, will not reach us. And you see, while the Egyptians were fleeing into it, so the Lord overthrew the Egyptians in the midst of the sea. This is the God I love, the God I preach. This is God that we need to love and to walk with and to hear as he says, go forward. Do you know what he does? The Egyptians had not seen it before. Before their animals were killed, their water was interfered with when they were in Egypt. They could see lice, they could see frogs. But this one, God dealt with them. The only human being God had touched were the sons during the night of Exodus. But this time, dealing with them, the army, the strongest place, that is what God can do. I ask you a question. What is your problem? What are your issues? What are your circumstances? What are your dreams before God? Our God is able. Rise on your feet and let's say a prayer together. Hallelujah. The word says, we are moving forward. Moving forward. The scouts say, forward ever, backward never. Don't be held back by your past, by your behind, said Apostle Paul. One thing I do, I forget. Why do I forget? I can afford to be careless about what is pursuing me because God is taking care. And I want to be concerned about my forward movement. Hallelujah. I'm staying in a place where I see so many vehicles. They are green car and they are calling forward. That means if you are not careful on the road, you'll find it rough because the forward vehicle must remain ahead of you. Let me tell you, forward is the move, is the direction. Why don't you say a prayer for God in a minute in the name of Jesus? Tell the Holy Spirit to help you, even to cultivate the forward movement in the name of Jesus. Yes, we are moving on. We are moving forward. This is our direction. We are not turning back. We are not dying here. We are not going sideways. We are moving forward. This is our determination. This is our area. My God, my God, my God. And Jehovah Rakandolosa. Leketemosi Makando. Jehovah God, I declare. Our way is forward. Our movement is forward. Oh yes, Jehovah. Blessed be your name, the King of glory, Jehovah El Shaddai. You are faithful, God. We trust in your word. We trust in your voice. We trust in your action. We trust in your direction. In the mighty name of Jesus, I declare victory. My God, the way opening for your children. We are moving forward. You are rainbow, my God. Where there is no hope, you give us hope. Thank you, Jehovah. I give you praise. I declare to every viewer, to every listener, everybody under my voice, that the power of the Holy Ghost shall flow upon us, giving us courage, giving us even the sight and to move forward in the name of Jesus. May every frustration and disappointment be under our feet in the name of Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. Blessed be your name. Father, I declare blessings upon everyone. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And the church say, amen and amen.